big as it could possibly be. So in the same way that we're keeping income items off of our tax return in that base year, we also want to keep itemized deductions off that base year tax return as well.
Okay, so you're a CPA and you're doing families' taxes. I'm sure you hear often families saying, huh? Aren't I supposed to maximize my deduction so I minimize my tax?
So this- absolutely. And you know what? It is. It's so hard to get your mind around it. But, you know, it's funny. And let me just tell you about this case that I just did yesterday for a family. They came in. When we did this base year planning for them, what we do is we take their last year's tax return and say, okay, here's what we want you to do, and here's what your tax return might look like going forward. The changes that we suggested had about a $2,000 swing in their taxes, and in this case, it actually saved them money on taxes, but the difference in their financial aid eligibility was almost $7,000 per year per student. For a family, you know, that has more than one kid, I mean, we're talking about a tremendous thousands of dollars of savings, and if you take that $7,000 swing in their financial aid eligibility over a four-year period, that's $28,000 just for one student.
Well, that's a big number, and I think families want to understand it. So can you give us a couple of examples of what would be things to look at or types of... We've talked about the income, and I don't know if there's any other examples of income other than deferring a bonus unless you're self-employed.
Well, yeah,
but what about deductions? Oh, okay.
Yeah, and let me tell you about that. What we're going to be trying to do there is the timing of capital gains. You know, a lot of times a family, perhaps they have an investment account, they've got stocks, you know, whatever, that they've set aside specifically to pay for college. Well, if that's the case, eventually they're going to have to, you know, liquidate that money in order, you know, cash those investments in to get the cash to send to, you know, to the universities. We would absolutely not want them doing that in the base year because, you know, particularly if it's going to result in capital gains, again, that will be reported as income on that base year tax return. So, you know, things like that. And even maybe not that you wanted to use that money for college, maybe you wanted to buy a new car, whatever. You know, we just want you, if you need to access money in investment accounts that you're going to have gains on, we do not want you tapping into that in your base year because we do not want to increase your income in that year.
So that's a big deal for families because they've got to think about planning for those capital gains, especially now where the market's done this big upturn recently, that they want to be able to plan to sell if they're going to need cash in the next year to be selling in the junior year for the other student, which is earlier than most families would be thinking about it. And we definitely run into families that walk in the door with capital gains that are a big bummer on the calculation.
Well, and that's true. And, you know, a lot of times when we're looking at the asset end of things, you know, if we're going to be thinking of repositioning assets in order to help a family qualify for more aid, that's a whole other topic, right?
That'd be another show.
Yeah, that'd be another show. But if they are wanting to do that, then we're going to be wanting to do that prior to that base year. And that's why it's so important to get started, you know, on looking at your college plan, you know, way ahead of the game.
Let's look at some examples of how you can maximize your taxes.
Okay, here's what we would, for example, you know, the best, you know, obviously the biggest itemized deductions that most people have are mortgage interest and or property taxes. So, for example, you know, mortgage interest is typically due on the first of the month, your mortgage payment, but it's not considered to be late until the 15th of the month. So, for example, if it's December of your junior year and your mortgage payment is coming up, you want to make sure that you make that payment in December before the base year because you want to take that deduction before the base year because you want to minimize your itemized deductions. So the interest that you're paying in that payment, you want to be reported in the year prior to your base year, and property taxes same way. I know states different even by county, the timing of property tax payments is different. But if you can, you know, if you get the bill in December and it's due in the middle of January, make sure that you pay it in December before the base year. Or conversely, if it's for the bill for after, if it's the end of your senior year, make sure that you wait till January to pay it.
And another example I know that we run in with families is their choices of donating to charity, to if they want to donate for that year, that they could donate in the non-base year, either the junior year or after the college, the student's already in college.
Absolutely. And again, we're not suggesting at all that they forego making contributions to their favorite charity. We're just asking that they change the timing of it so that they can maximize their financial aid eligibility.
One of the other income items that we didn't talk about that I always like to mention with families is that you really want to avoid having any IRA distributions or to actually cash in IRAs that year of the base year, because that, even though you feel like you're just cashing in your own money, that ends up showing up as income on your tax return also.
Right, absolutely. And you know, while you are talking about IRAs, you know, when we're talking about assets that are included in a financial aid formula, retirement accounts are not included. So, in other words, if you had $10,000 in a savings account down the street, you would have to report that as an asset. If you had $10,000 in your 401k, you do not report that because obviously they do not expect you to tap into your retirement funds to pay for college. But if you take distributions from those accounts, then they are reported on your tax return and they do count as income. So, yeah, you're going to want to absolutely not, if you can avoid it, take distributions in your base year.
Yeah, that's so the managing of the income and the deductions is a big, it is going to be a big issue for families to think about. I really appreciate you, Jody, coming on the show to talk about this base year planning. Thanks so much for sharing your knowledge and experience and joining us on College Smart Radio today.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
We've been talking with Jody Arimo about how families need to use base year planning tax strategies well before their high school students reach their senior year to increase their financial aid eligibility and pay less for college. In many cases, by doing nothing more than managing the timing of certain income and deductions. That wraps up another weekly show of College Smart Radio. We hope you've picked up some new information today that helps you figure out ways to manage the runaway cost of college. You can hear us each week here on KDOW 1220 AM Saturdays at 3 p.m. We promise to bring you up-to-date information from the front lines of helping Bay Area parents deal with the most expensive years of their lives. For a link to a podcast of this show and our prior weekly shows, go to our website, www.collegesmartradio.com. In addition to the podcast, you'll also find a schedule of our upcoming shows. Also, if you missed the free community college funding workshop that I hosted this morning, our next two workshops will be on Wednesday, October 10th, and Saturday morning, November 3rd at a San Carlos facility. So if you're interested, do reserve your seat because they do run out. And you can do so from our show's website, www.collegesmartradio.com. This is Beatrice Schultz. Thanks for tuning in to College Smart Radio. We look forward to sharing more helpful information next week.
You've been listening to College Smart Radio with certified financial planner Beatrice Schultz. If you have a question on today's topic, log on to collegesmartradio.com or call area code 650-587-1517. That's 650-587-1517. Join us next week at this time for another edition of College Smart Radio on AM 1220 KDOW.